Don't move it. Okay, so in world building, let's have a look around the space here today. And as you spawn, you will have this museum around you. Obviously, again, there's this Archviz Pro artifacts. Yeah, so the story is that it's a museum. It has a combination of classic architectural elements inside. So there you'll see the pavilion. That is the 1939 pavilion of the New York City World's Fair. And that is a piece of family history, the Dutch pavilion. If you go and back a little bit more, here, you should be able to look up and see the entire pavilion. You can also get up there by walking there. There will be room for displaying. I think this is a particularly nice... There's going to be a couple of hidden passages as well. But there will be spaces like this for hanging like a giant whale or something like that. I'm still under 100k polygons. And under 180 megabytes, so we have the tracking lists here of the sprint. But I think it's particularly nice. It's running now, pretty decent. The way you come into the space, there's still some over-lighted areas. But let's have a tour of things that are working. So we can jump over these little bridges and then have a look around in the space, kind of like a pool area, right? There's a beautiful space to put an object underneath. All those niche corners in the building are areas where you can hang something up. I think once it gets filled, it will feel less like a prison. And then I successfully managed to clean up some lighter areas, and there up there is a portal. We did go and see June yesterday, but this is obviously a style that I normally already kind of adhere to. I have a simple, pure, simple design style. And then you see the pavilion there is much brighter, so you can go from the basement all the way to the top in this architectural journey. Then we have a couple of surprises. Here there's another one. You can literally walk up to this historical artifact that will be later on combined with antiques that you can really purchase on the website. Maybe I can actually show that real quick. That later on we will actually go and combine it with real pieces. So we will have the real pieces scanned, wrought iron, folk art, miscellaneous. The idea is that we will scan these, and there's some very simple things, and then also scan the textures, for example, and then you can also actually purchase the objects. Maritime. So these beautiful boats, for instance, are ready for sale, as you can see, and then later these might be part of the heritage. It's 325 euros. We might actually scan it, rebuild it in Gravity Sketch, put it on there. So it's also, my uncle asked me to help with the website as well. So going back to the playground, you'll see that we actually have a fully interactive space that is going to be using LiDAR scanning in this sense, not for autonomous full self-driving. So I'm trying to get these kind of Villeneuve-esque kind of simple graphics going with light. So let's go upstairs and see if we can catch some sun rays up top. Are we recording? No, we should be recording. Streaming, yeah. So here, for example, you have an empty space, but you can see the pavilion nicely from here. And we can add some more detail, but obviously it's a good view from here. You can see the pavilion, you can see the the pool, the sitting areas, and let's go upstairs. Oh yeah, this step is still a little bit too big, so I have to do a little bit of a run. So it's a bit game-like, which I'm not sure if that's the way we want to do it. But as you can see, you'll see the blue glow already a little bit here. And that's the glow of the museums. There will be some photos of the museum hanging in there already later. It's the glow of the museums. And then you can have a nice view downwards. People are sitting there, for instance. You see the sunlight coming in. You feel less like you're in prison already. And then this place was much lighter before. It's a bit out of scale at the moment, but you can imagine putting a beautiful piece above here. There's a plateau here. We have very nice lit ceiling. It looks like the posts are not yet correctly positioned. Sorry, I'm a little tired. And there you see this kind of portal. So that's actually a portal. Well, you're looking at a portal, so you could actually jump to it, which is a bit strange, I think. But I wanted to show you the other side, which I'll show you now. Let's jump over there. And voila, a very nice, larger than life. So if I do the full person, you get this contrast. It's old and new, which is hilarious. But this liner, as you can see, with currently a decent speed H for controls, we're running at 60 frames per second. I don't know if all computers can do that, but that's working. So yeah, you get a little bit of a view of the space. Tomorrow we have texture improvements. We have audio, video, and 2D art, 2D posters, as well as continuing to improve the path. He doesn't get into the sun because there's no real dynamic light, so he doesn't really appear into the sun. A little bit dune maybe, but I think as a museum, what you will notice is once you start adding the artifacts, it'll become a lot more clear what this space is. Let's see if we can do the portal real quick. There it is. If you are actually pointing at it exactly. Funny. Kind of hard to find that portal. There you go. Boom. Click, and now you spawn from there. Well, this is the portal. A little bit Dune-ish, yeah, but this I had built before Dune, even before I went there yesterday. And you can even go behind the money secret piece of art. Yeah, so there are all jump platforms and things everywhere, and even if you end up in the pool, you can still, I used to spawn in this pool, I don't know why, but you can still jump up and jump up and jump up and get out of the pool. So let me post this video of the progress and say, okay, this is the space. Artifact. If you look at the artifact, you spawn also somewhere. I don't really understand why. And with that, tomorrow we go to art pieces, textures, but I'm proud that I've been able to connect historic elements, 1939 Pavilion, with some, oh my god, what is this thing? This is super bright. With some, yeah, it makes it a lot nicer. With, if you good use of light, will make textures look less terrible. So I try to keep it light. Anyway, it's architectural, it's historic, it has history combined with the future. I think the history of the future has always been this theme that I've been busy with. And proud to have come this far now, and tomorrow another sprint. We have T-minus 4 days. So we're gonna go all out, because this is for me the start of the NFT building. And is it very annoying, the video, if I jump around on this? No, it's doable. You get a good flavor. And good news, people, the fog is actually working, so it's looking really good. Look at the light, the sunlight is just, I just adore that. I do need to ask if I can actually have this blanket in there, and the so all I have now is this blanket, this thing, and this couch from Archviz Pro. I'm sure, hope you're okay with it. It's more a prop that you buy in an asset store, right? It should be okay. Mute audio, third person, hide UI, camera, so what's camera sensitivity doing? I think we just want to leave that alone. Yeah, it's fun to walk around.
Okay.
Tomorrow, the next blog, and with that, build better Mana. We're signing off.